what's up, my hippie? What's up, my hippie? See me in your city. Say, what's up, my hippie? What's up, my hippie?
I fall. That Kelly.
See me in your city. Say, what's up, my hippie? What's up, my hippie?
Now I'm never gonna sleep again. Let's turn this to a never-ending evening. Pants blow his ass out of heat in. Good karma, I'm on the receiving end. Never growing up like Mr. Penn. Bumping old school like the shows on TV land. I'm warming up, I don't need a fan. You ain't down with Rasta, my gosh, shots. Still at least the man, cause I ain't putting this grid there out for nobody. You can do what you do, just don't do nothing to my party. I'm already a regular in favor, also a savior. I got my own flavor, I don't do it nothing like your neighbor.
Burr.
But I'm sure you knew that. It's impossible to keep a secret. If you rap better than I do that, give me every detail and make it juice. Gotta tell the world about the movie, how you live it out fully, how you keep it so groovy. Let them know. If you see me in your city, say what's up, my
hey,
hippie.
And what is up, everybody? Michael Buckhusher here with the Man Hour After Hours with my man, Brandon Combs.
What's up, my hippie?
What is going on?
So hey, look.
I was introduced to Mod Sun, the guy who sings that song, when I went to an MGK concert here in Louisville about, I don't know, 3 or 4 years ago. Cindy took it to me for my birthday, actually.
I love some MGK, man.
And, dude, so when you walk in, you see this big old picture of, like, Mod Sun. He is wearing, like, this freaking seven-piece suit, right? Like, he has the vest and, like, the bote on it and, like, everything. He has his long, curly-ass hair. And I'm like, man, this guy is either going to really fucking suck or he's going to kill it, right?
Yeah.
Fucking murdered it, man.
Yeah.
By far the best stage show I've ever seen.
He's pretty good.
Yeah.
MGK, man, that's my guy. When I'm down and out and I need like something to make me feel a little bit better about life and how shit's going, MGK's my guy, man. That Glass House song that he's got is that's a pick me up for sure.
Yeah, I am not a huge fan of his new album. What is his new album called? The Tickets to My Townfall.
Yep.
It really reminds me of Blink 182, too, we'll be honest.
Yeah, he's a super talented guy, though. MGK is ultra talented. He's a lot like who's the other guy out there?
Eminem?
Well, Eminem, obviously. I love Eminem. No. But I'm talking about God, I can't think of his name right now. He's got all the face tattoos.
Post Malone.
Super talented. Right. Super talented guy. Just not, you know, not everybody's cup of tea.
Yeah. like, honestly, there's a lot of good artists out there, like, right now. And later in the show, like, if there's time, we are going to talk of, like, who is, like, what is the best song of, like, all time. And piping in over here on the Man Hour YouTube page, we have Shadow Gamer coming in saying,
"What's going on, Shadow Gamer?"
Man, I'm glad. So Shadow Gamer has been in here every time we have done the Man Hour After Hours, and thank you for joining us, man. Be sure to hit that like button as soon as you can. But Brandon, we are going to have a special guest on, Mike LeBlanc.
Oh,
and,
Mike LeBlanc's coming on our show.
Yeah, he is coming on our show, the After Hours show. And if you guys watched the Mike and Mike Man Hour this afternoon, Mike was already tipping back some whiskey and like Coke. So I'm kind of curious to see what he's doing right now. So let's welcome him on to the show. Mike, what's up, man?
I don't see any Coke in that one, though.
Thank you for welcoming me to my show. Mike and Mike Man Hour.
Yeah. No, sir. This is the Buck and Combs Man Hour After Dark, sir. You're a guest in my house, bro.
No, I'm not a guest here.
you certainly don't live here.
Oh, I live here, sir.
I mean, look at the backdrop here. It says After Dark. It don't say nothing about Mike and Mike. Even the little thing in the corner right there just says After Dark Man Hour. There ain't no Mike and Mike on that thing, man.
Hey, Buck, we're going to change that tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
That's an executive order, okay?
Okay. I mean, to be honest, Mike did say, hey, let's rebrand the show to Man Hour. And then I'm like, you know what? Right on.
But see, when you're on my show, I also have control, too. So, see, I can take you out anytime I want to, LeBlanc. So.
Oh, Wow. You are the weakest link. Goodbye. So, Mike,
where are you at, Cones?
Did you catch any of TSS, man? Because I went off on TSS.
I snapped.
We started talking baseball and Justin Turner, and I snapped. It led into baseball being stupid. It led into me talking about politics. It was 10-minute rant that was not good.
The Yankees got kicked out of the playoffs. So after that, I didn't fucking pay attention. Although.
Hang on. Betts. Pause 1 second.
Mookie Betts. Holy shit.
He is pretty damn good. Let's be flat honest.
Yeah.
But pause 1 second. Mike, you are a stereotypical Cowboys fan. You like the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Yankees. Like, if you can peg a Yankees fan or a Cowboys fan, it is you 100%.
Basically, you're LeBron. Basically, you're LeBron James. You're a fan of whoever's winning at the time.
Hold on, I just need to admire myself.
We are on the radio, man. Jesus. I cannot wait until your hair falls out.
My hair will never fall. You see this?
You should shave yours like Buck.
No.
Mine is elective hair growth. Like it chooses to grow like that.
No, I just look like a penis with ears if I fucking shave.
You look like a penis with ears now.
No, I'm sexy. So
you just look like a hairy penis with ears.
So, Mike, Brandon and I were worried. We were talking pre-show, and Brandon mentioned that he was drinking some Crown tonight, right?
Brandon, no, I got a. Have you ever heard of Kraken rum?
Kraken rum, sorry.
Yeah, like the Kraken, you know, the release the Kraken. It's a type of spiced rum. It's a dark rum, but it's sweeter than Captain Morgan. So I like to have that with some cherry Pepsi.
Mike, have you ever had that?
No, I'm not a bitch. I drink my whiskey straight.
So. Oh. All right.
So on that note, guys, let's go ahead and get into today's show. As the NFL deadline is coming near, I am going to propose a question here. So we're all NFL fans. You know, I'm a Chiefs fan. Mike, you are a Cowboys/Packers fan.
Brandon, you like that, right, Cones? You like that.
And Brandon, you are a Chicago fan, so you are a Bears fan. So with all that being said, what are some moves? Brandon, I want to come to you first. What is one move that you really want to see made before the trade deadline happens on November
4th? All right. So I've been thinking about it a lot, and I'm not even going to go with the Bears here. There are a couple Bears I like to see the moves I like to see the Bears make, but I'm not so sure it's going to happen. One move, and Mike LeBlanc might be interested to hear this, and I threw this out on TSS, is how about the Cowboys ship off a first, a third, and next year's second round pick to New England for Cam Newton and Stephon Gilmore. And the Dallas Cowboys come out and win the NFC East. That would get you, because Cam Newton's the throw-in in that trade, because if you trade Cam Newton straight up, you're not getting more than a sixth or seventh round pick for him.
True.
But Stephon Gilmore, Defensive Player of the Year, Stephon Gilmore, is going to command a first-round pick, a third, a second, maybe a second. You give up those picks, and you go and you get, and you compete this year. And the Dallas Cowboys, with that trade right there, Buckheister, where you said that an NFC East team is going to make the NFC Championship game, I think that would do it.
I said first-round win is what I said.
Look, Stephon Gilmore, wow. I mean,
they need defensive help, but they also need a quarterback, and they get both in that trade.
I don't think they need – so the more and more I think about this, Combs, I don't think they need quarterback help. I think Andy Dalton can weather them through the storm this season. I think they need offensive line help.
No, you need defensive help. The defense is bad. I mean, they were doing good things on offense. They were doing really with Dak in there before Dak got hurt, they were a top three offense.
Right.
So offense is the problem. Defense is the problem. They need defensive help.
Well, the and like I don't think defense is really the problem. It's the defensive coach that is the problem. It is a scheme.
Wade Phillips. They,
well, no, but like seriously, when Wade Phillips was the defensive coordinator for the Dallas Cowboys, they were not giving up 40 points a game.
I do like the trade. I do like him and Stephon Gilmore for his first, second, and sixth round pick. I do like that.
The problem with that though is you have a free agent out there by the name of Earl Thomas that could demand $1 million.
So go get him.
Yeah, why hasn't
Andy go get him and make that trade? And now you are the absolute favorite in the NFC East, a really bad NFC East.
Why hasn't anybody gone out and got Earl Thomas?
There has to be something happening. I mean, like
I think it's the Kaepernick thing again. I think you're on the down climb of your career, and right. your help to my team doesn't outweigh your distraction to my team, and that's exactly what happened with Kaepernick. I mean, Kaepernick, everybody's like, oh, they blackballed Kaepernick, blah, 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 because he kneeled and all that stuff. No, he went from a Super Bowl quarterback to an 8-8 quarterback to a 2-10 quarterback, and then his play was outweighed by his distraction. I mean, and that's why nobody signed him.
And on the flip side, that when we think of Earl Thomas, we think of Seattle Seahawks Earl Thomas. We're not thinking Baltimore Ravens. So
we lost Seahawks. LeBlanc.
Yeah,
he got so mad at that trade he left.
I'm coming to put the game on.
Oh,
I'm coming to put the game on.
So Brandon, I do like that trade in theory, but let's be honest. Cam Newton went to the Patriots for trade bait, right?
Yeah.
I mean, absolutely. So when you say Cam Newton's is being thrown in there as a kicker, I think Cam Newton wouldn't be thrown in there as a kicker. You're not getting anybody
to give you more than a sixth or seventh round pick for Cam Newton.
You are 100% correct, but you're also not going to give any like the Dallas Cowboys won't get more than a sixth or seventh round pick for any.
But that's where you get when you throw Cam Newton in with a Stephon Gilmore. That's where what gets you that extra pick. So instead of just getting a first and a third, now you're also getting next year's second and probably a fifth or fourth or fifth somewhere in that area. That's what Cam Newton brings to that trade. He brings you that one extra pick.
So
is what you're getting.
So let me propose this question for you, or kind of like this statement. I mean, many people, Wayne G from Infinity Sports, says that Jared Stidham is the future in New England. Do you really think Jared Stidham is the future in New England? And if so, why wouldn't Bill Belichick be more aggressive of moving Cam?
Because it's time to rebuild, and that's the future for New England, is a rebuild. It's not Stidham, it's not Gilmore, it's not that defense. The future for New England is a rebuild. And do they've got the pieces on defense to build around. But it's going to take some time. They've got nothing on offense. They've got no line. They've got no receivers. They've got no running back. They've got no quarterback. The time has finally come where we are about to see the New England Patriots be an annual 3-13, 4-12, 5-11 team for the next 5 years.
That is not going to happen. And you know that. So let me ask you this. Because just 2 weeks ago, when Cam Newton was playing at his best, right, the New England Patriots were saying this is a Super Bowl bound team. Are they just a quarterback away? Should the Patriots be interested in getting an Andy Dalton, for example, or maybe a Jalen Hurt or Fitzpatrick?
Who the heck is Richard Tipton? Coach, and why Tip. Is he saying I'm stealing his take? Oh, that's Tip.
Yeah, that's Tip. That's Coach Tip.
I didn't even know that was your take. I actually, you know, pulled that out of the top of my head earlier on my show.
Before he pulled it out of his ass.
But it's a good trade though, ain't it?
You know, the more I sit back and think about it, Mike, you as a Cowboys fan, you should be jumping for joy for this.
I want
You want what?
I like Gilmore because I like the secondary help. But I'm cool with Andy Dalton. I'm cool with rocking with Andy Dalton. I just want offensive line help.
I'm not saying get rid of Andy Dalton because you aren't trading him away.
So,
you're just
I'm saying you're getting Gilmore, but they're throwing in Cam Newton. You don't want an upgrade at quarterback? He's definitely an upgrade from Andy Dalton, right?
I don't think so, because watching Cam Newton right now, he's got no help.
He's got no weapons. Cam Newton would be amazing. Well, I'd take Cam Newton in Chicago.
Cam Newton looks like he's losing heart and he's losing passion.
No.
Yeah, I agree with that. Yeah.
Cam Newton's got no weapons. He's got no help. He's got nothing. He's got to do it all on his own. It showed in that Seattle game. The only reason they were in that Seattle game was because he brought them back.
He's fucking playing with heart. And he looks like he's out there fucking hurt. If you want my honest opinion, looks like he's fucking hurt.
Yep. If you watch him throw last game, who they played last game? I forget. But he is dropping that shoulder again, and he's like shot putting the ball. So
Coach Chip says Cam would be a great backup to Dak next year. He wouldn't back up Dak next year. First of all, if they're not Dak's
a Cam Newton is going to be the starter for the New England Patriots next year.
No, he's not.
And who I think it
no,
was,
he's not.
I think it was Combs. I think you're looking at the Patriots. Yes, over the next 2 or 3 years, you're looking at the Patriots being the 3-13, 4-12 team.
But not with Cam Newton at the helm. No way.
Or with Bill there. Like, let's be flat out honest. Bill Belichick will never have them below seven wins.
I mean, he's going to have them below seven wins this year.
Yeah, no, he's not. No, he's not.
They'll be below
seven. They're winning seven games right now, Buck. What are you seeing that shows you they're winning seven games next year?
I am seeing that the NFL is the most reactive, most bipolar sport out there. Just 2 weeks ago, before Cam Newton got COVID, the week before the Chiefs game, we all sat on our individual shows and said that the Patriots were a Super Bowl bound team.
I didn't say they were Super Bowl bound. I said they were impressing me and they were better than I thought that they were. But then they came back down to earth. They had what we saw with the Patriots early on in the season was the product of there not being a preseason and no game film on what the Patriots were running with Cam, and they shocked a couple of teams. Look, man, and they played better than what they were.
Josh McDaniels is, I think he's a great offensive coordinator, and what he's doing with Cam is just, I mean, it's either McDaniels or it's fucking Cam, one of the two, and I tend to believe it is Cam. Watching him last game, he just kind of stood back in the pocket and was just like, meh.
On the flip side of the Cam Newton playing bad last game, right, he also did have one practice in like 16 days.
Last week's game was – 2 weeks ago was the game that he had one practice in 16 games.
Right, I'm sorry.
Last week he had a full week of practice. He still looked bad. That offense looks bad.
But if
he's got no help.
If you flashback to the beginning of the season,
they're going to lose Amendola.
All right. So
that motherfucker looked so fucking pissed off on the sidelines and on the field last week.
Because he's overrated. He's terrible.
Yeah, he's terrible.
No. Shut up.
Amendola's terrible.
Even
Amendola was good because Tom Brady made Amendola good.
So
and this year, Tom Brady would even make him good.
Wait. Tom Brady is the one who fucking made him.
Yes.
Get the fuck out of here.
Listen, certain times.
I will gladly take Amendola on the Cowboys. That little white boy will fucking go out and fucking go get it.
He will go get it, but also a quarterback has to throw him open. Cam Newton doesn't know how to throw players open. Andy Dalton doesn't know how to throw players open. Tom Brady knows how to throw players open.
When he bobbled the ball in the Super Bowl and made that miraculous catch, that was Tom Brady?
Okay, so when you are right. That is not Tom Brady,
Amendola.
Okay, so he made one great catch. Congratulations!
Oh my god!
What a fucking great catch! What are you talking?
Look,
about?
I'm gonna throw out some names to you here. Troy Brown.
Who?
Yeah. Exactly. But you know what? When he was in New England, Tom Brady made him look like a superstar.
Yeah, 100% correct.
Danny Amendola is on that same level. So, and I'm going to go one further for you. Not only is Danny Amendola on that level, but the other one that's on that level is number 11, Julian Edelman, is on that level too. Julian Edelman is good because of Tom Brady.
And he is the one that went to the Denver Broncos, right, with Peyton Manning and never panned out at all, right? Yeah, because Tom Brady made him better.
But Danny Amendola can go to another team and fucking ball out.
No.
I'm done.
I y'all look fucking retarded. I'm done.
I don't.
You got fucking Combs who thinks fucking Jameis Winston is better than Drew Brees. Now you're telling me that fucking Danny Amendola is a fucking horrible wide receiver?
I'm not saying he is a horrible wide receiver, but if you
right now and say lick these, because if you, both of you are fucking smoking crack.
Mike. You could put him on camera, but that camera doesn't zoom in that far.
okay.
He's speechless. But with it, Mike,
I will put him on camera. I mean,
think about this. Let's just stick to the top 10 teams in all of the NFL. Danny Amendola does not make any of those teams better.
You what?
Correct.
False.
You are looking at the top 10 teams in the NFL.
Oh, my God.
He is not making any of those teams better.
He does.
He doesn't.
How does he make them better? Put him on the Kansas City Chiefs.
He's open when you need him to. He is clutch when you need him to. Stop.
So when they needed him last week, what happened then?
I'm
asking you a question.
You know my hatred for the Patriots.
Yes, I do.
Why are we talking about Amendola on the Patriots anyway? Amendola's not on the Patriots.
Is he not?
No, he's on the Lions.
Wait, who the fuck am I thinking about?
Are you talking about Julian Edelman?
Yes. Edelman. There we go. My bad. I'm thinking about the wrong motherfucker.
You're over here getting all hyped up. You don't even know who you're talking about.
I always get them confused. Edelman. That's what I'm
saying. Edelman is only a good wide receiver, too, because of the system.
You are fucking cracking.
Here I was thinking you were talking about Amendola like he was a superstar. At first, I was like, this guy's really drinking his whiskey. He's drinking a lot of whiskey today if he thinks Amendola is a stud.
No, Edelman, you're right. I misspoke. My bad. No, I don't get Amendola and Edelman confused. They're both fucking little small white boys.
They are both white and they both have beards. So, I mean, they all look the same.
Edelman. yes, Edelman. Like, dude, like, the catch in the Super Bowl was amazing.
Mike, you are right. With Tom Brady at the helm, Coach Tip brought up three names here: Wes Welker, Edelman, and Amendola.
All were good because they played with Tom Brady.
Because he threw them open. They are not good route runners.
They all run one route. They all run a slant.
Right.
That's the only route they run. And it drives me nuts. It used to drive me nuts because when I lived in New England, that's all I got to see your Patriots game. I was like, how can nobody stop the slant route? But they just didn't. I don't know why, but they didn't because Brady does things that I don't know how. He's just Tom Brady.
Right. So, guys,
Jackson, who do we think will win the NFC East? I think we all have the Eagles winning the NFC East.
No, I have the Cowboys.
Well, because you're smoking crack. You fucking just...
No, because of what you said about the Andy...
If they make that trade, then yes, they're the favorites of the East.
That defense is fucking atrocious. No.
It is.
But we don't play in a defense win championship era anymore. We play...
What is their offense going to do, though? What has that offense done since Dak went down?
They had one off week. They had one off week.
One?
Yeah, last week versus the Redskins or the football team.
Come on, man.
they scored three.
He's yelling at you from his bathroom.
Because
three points.
They had one bad week. Look at what they've done the rest of the season. I believe every game is over 25 points
against the fucking Eagles. That's a loss.
They're going to score 40 plus points next week versus the Eagles.
What? With the new team?
Yes. I believe no, Mike. You are the one that's said that you can
look,
put any quarterback.
I just love DeAndre Hopkins on the Patriots. I mean, DeAndre Hopkins is a great Patriots wide receiver. Since we just make every wide receiver a Patriots wide receiver, we're going to talk about players that aren't on the team being on the team.
So Loco Jackson says yes, the Cowboys do allow 36 points a game, but when you average 38 points a game, you're going to win.
What the hell is he smoking, dude?
He's talking to you.
No,
because you are crazy.
I guarantee he's not talking to me. He's talking to you. He's saying you really think that the fucking Cowboys are going to put up 40 fucking 6 points?
The Cowboys aren't going to win anything until Jerry Jones brings in an actual general manager.
Stephen Jones is doing a great job. Look at those.
Stephen Jones.
look at the draft picks that they've done the last 5 or 6 years. Think about this. If that Cowboys offensive line hasn't been injury plagued the last year and a half, they have had the best, arguably the best offensive line for the last 5 or 6 years. Just as last year and a half, they've been injury plagued. Well, let's be honest. They've been injury plagued.
They have, but you
and there's to, and you, they are still competing with third and fourth stringers in there.
46 points with the new team.
Here,
40.
All right. 40. Let me rein you guys in just a little bit here. Another trade that I think would be a good trade, but it would never happen in a million years because the Bears are too tied up on. They had to either be right with Nick Foles or Mitch Trubisky. The Bears should absolutely go and look at Miami and try to get Fitzpatrick. The Bears are a Super Bowl team with Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Oh.
And that defense. No. Oh, absolutely. 110%.
With Fitzmagic?
Yes. Yes. Because they got wide receivers that get open downfield, but no quarterback that can hit them. Fitzpatrick is that guy.
He doesn't have an arm.
And that would make this team really, really dangerous. This offense would then be at least able to score 24 points a game, and you're not scoring 24 points on this defense.
So the only question that I have or concern that I have is what would be the trade in return to Miami? Because let's be honest, you are going to have to give up some piece of your defense, some piece of your offense.
You can give up a piece of your defense for that because the Bears are so deep in defense. Plus, give up a fourth round pick. Yeah. Remember, it's Ryan Fitzpatrick, and he's riding your bench. So maybe a small piece of your defense, it's not going to be you're not going to give up Fuller. You might go out and give up. Pick one of our safeties. You have one of our safeties and our fourth round pick.
Mike.
I like that idea, but I don't think it would never happen. The Bears aren't going to move off of Foles or Trubisky.
So
you're crazy. You're fucking like absolutely fucking just bananas. You're 42 points with DiNucci. Like, yeah, I'm still on that shit. Yeah, Combs, I'm sorry. I just can't let that shit go. You're going to fucking...
First of all, I did not say 46 or 42. I said 40. 4-0.
I don't give a fuck.
Your age.
43. That's it. I'd be surprised if they get a fucking field goal.
DiNucci, this guy that's straight out of an Al Pacino film, is going to go ahead and put up 40 points. If they put up 40 points this weekend... Whoever the hell they're playing, I don't even know who the Cowboys got this week.
Eagles.
Get done! You're out of your mind.
Okay,
come on.
You know what? I tell you what. I'll say it. You know what? If the Cowboys put up 40 points against the fucking Eagles with DiNucci, both me and Combs will come give you a hand job.
Well, first of all, I don't need you guys to give me a hand job because you guys already stuck in my dick as is. Because you guys have been.
How about this? If they put up 40 points, if they put up 40 points, or hell, if they beat the Eagles, I'll shave my head. I'll come on here looking like Buck. Mike, you with me?
Mike's not going to shave his head. he just grew his hair back out.
They are not putting up.
No, I mean no, dude. Like no, 40. No, they're not even winning.
40 points with an Italian cook.
No, like with DiNucci, there's not even a chance, bro. Like
Let's be honest. Like, let's like really be honest, Buck. Let's stop living in fantasy land. Okay? Let's come back down to reality for a minute. There's no way in fucking hell that the Cowboys are going to beat the Eagles with the new team.
Okay, well, since we are talking Cowboys again, and you want to not talk Fitzmagic First things first.
And you're fucking saying they're going to beat teams with their third string quarterback?
Well, first things first, has Andy Dalton been ruled out for this week? The answer to that question is no, he hasn't. I think Andy Dalton is going to play.
Andy Dalton is still laying on the stretcher.
No, he's not. He is.
Dude, that guy has not gotten off the stretcher.
He's waiting for his soul to come back in.
He is still, yeah, he's still half dead.
Speaking of which, I am in an NFC East trash talk group, and they showed a picture of Andy Dalton getting walked off the field. He shit his pants. So I just want to point that out there. That was kind of funny.
He's probably still shitting his pants. It's probably still coming out. That guy got murdered. I'm surprised they have not announced that he is dead yet. I think that they're just waiting because they don't want the bad publicity. But I mean, he died in that play.
Are you ready for me to tell you why the Cowboys are going to win this game? Do you guys really want to know why? Because
their defense is trash.
Okay.
And with DiNucci, their fucking offense now is like just straight garbage. I mean, come on.
You're going to say game plan for DiNucci, right?
No.
Is that what you're going to say?
You can game plan for whoever you want. But if DiNucci is in there, they are not going to be pushing the ball down the field, right? The Eagles' front seven is complete trash. When you know you have a seventh round quarterback, rookie quarterback in there, what are you going to do? You have to give Zeke the ball, and that is how the Cowboys win, giving Zeke Elliott the ball. 40-plus times in this game versus the Eagles, he's going to get the ball on screen passes, handoffs.
But he's going to have to run for, like, 300 yards, and he's going to have to score five times.
And Zeke is
–
That's
all you have to do.
Zeke is like a diesel engine. You got to keep feeding him the ball. Zeke will wear down. Zeke can run with nine guys in the box. They're going to get wore down. That quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys is just good enough to throw the ball 60 yards down the field to Amari Cooper saying, go get the ball one time.
That Bridgewater injury looks bad.
Hey, Teddy Bridgewater is down.
And he ain't getting up.
He ain't getting up either.
What happened? He take a headshot like Andy Dalton did?
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. Speaking of which, you see the new helmet sitting back here?
Well, hang on. We have to address this comment. Loco says Zeke Elliott isn't good anymore. Zeke Elliott is very, very good. It's just they're not giving him the ball right now for whatever reason.
Real quick, check out the new lid. Joe Montana.
Wow.
Autograph lid.
Joe Montana. Yeah.
That thing just came in today.
Send it to me.
Yeah, that ain't happening. Send me $600. I'll send it to you.
That's game. You should send it to me.
So hang on.
But at any rate,
$100 for that. A guy with that same with that same chrome look, Kansas City Chiefs helmet signed by Patrick Mahomes is wanting $1,500.
Well, yeah, but that one's this is a replica. That's not a authentic. Authentic is $15,000 to $2,000.
Okay.
But at any rate, look, Zeke, Loco Jackson, I want to agree with you because I don't like the Dallas Cowboys. I don't like Zeke. But the numbers are, I mean, you're wrong. Zeke has been the best running back in the NFL since he came into the NFL. The numbers show that, and it's not even really close. And I tried. We did this debate on our show where we did the best 10 quarterbacks, and I really wanted to put Zeke down at like 4 or 5, and I just couldn't. Zeke is the best running back in the NFL. Who are you waving at?
His kids, I think.
Hey, don't fucking worry about it, Combs. How about that?
What are you on? Pornhub Live or something?
Maybe. Shit.
I mean.
So let's go ahead and make this full circle. Let's talk Fitzpatrick to the Chicago Bears. I don't think Fitzpatrick makes the Chicago Bears any more of a threat than what they are now. I think Nick Foles is better than Fitzpatrick moving forward, because you would be looking at a rent a player like at that point. And I don't think the Chicago Bears need that.
You get it. Yes, you do. And here's why. And that's the same thing that Hoffy brought up to me when I mentioned this to him. But it's not true, because with the Bears sitting, if the Bears go out and they make a run, say they even win the Super Bowl, okay, and say you're picking at 30, 32, 31, 30, wherever you're picking, wherever you lose in the playoffs is where you're picking. So you're picking down late in the draft. You still got a Kellen Mond or a Kyle Trask available in the first round or even in the second round. You still have your quarterback of the future ready for you, because that's already at 5 wins. You're not picking till 7th or 8th anyway. So your top two quarterbacks are already gone.
Who are you referring to? The Miami Dolphins, like, at this point?
No, the Bears. Because if you bring over your if you bring over Fitzmagic to the Bears, right, you're giving up your 4th or your 5th round pick, correct, plus your piece on defense. And no matter how, because I think Fitzpatrick makes them a real threat in the NFC. So even if they get bounced the NFC Championship game, if they get bounced, you know, wherever they get bounced and wherever they're picking, they've still got their pick late in the draft. Because you can still, like I said, you can still find a Kellen Mond or a Kyle Trask late in the first round or in the second round. So absolutely, 100%.
So you think if you think Fitzpatrick. I like to call him Fitzmagic. You think him going to the Bears makes them a Super Bowl contender?
I think if you get Fitzpatrick, I think if you get Sam Darnold, I think if you get Cam Newton, I think if you get any quarterback that can hit an open receiver downfield, I mean, to me, Sam Darnold, if you can go and get Sam Darnold, you give up two first round picks because he's your quarterback of the future. I think Sam Darnold is the real deal. He's just getting wasted away in New York.
He is
in the Jets. 100%.
Yeah, no, 100%.
So if you can get Sam Darnold, you give up the farm for Sam Darnold. That's fine with me.
They need to get up. They need to get rid of Gase. Gase, however the fuck you want to say his faggot ass name.
Right.
You need to get rid of him.
They need to get rid of Gase. They need to get rid of everybody. They really do.
Yeah, that GM.
They need to build. Yeah, they're a train wreck of an organization. But the Bears, if the Bears give up, you know, whatever they need to give up to get Fitzpatrick or even a Cam Newton, you give up whatever you get because you're still going to pick wherever you pick, and your guy is still going to be available. Because your guy is definitely a quarterback. Your guy is definitely a quarterback.
Hey, Buck.
Yeah.
Who did I pick to win?
I believe you picked the Falcons to win.
I did. Guess who's
up? I picked the Panthers, but I thought Teddy Bridgewater was playing the whole damn game, and
yeah, he just, I was not expecting coming back. I thought Teddy Bridgewater was playing pretty good that time that I was watching.
He was playing pretty good tonight.
But so when I think of when like you are saying the Bears can draft their quarterback of the future in the 4th round or 3rd round or whatever, right? Brandon, you as a Bears fan, you have been through this trouble that the Bears don't know how to draft. They passed on a quarterback by the name of Patrick Mahomes. Are you giving them faith to find a quarterback in the 3rd round after?
I give them faith later in the draft to not pass on a Kyle Trask or a Kellen Mond. If they had the number 2 pick, or if they had the number 1 pick, they would trade it to the 49ers and they would pick like a defensive lineman and pass on Trevor Lawrence, because that's what the Bears do.
Why would you pass on Trevor Lawrence? Hold on.
Because the Bears are stupid. Why would you pass on Deshaun Watson and Patrick Mahomes for freaking Mitchell Trubisky? Don't get me started, Mike LeBlanc, because they're the Bears, and that's what they do. They screw up drafts.
And they miss field goals in the playoffs to lose games. But so Brandon has given us two trades.
Brandon.
What?
Do me a favor. Take a deep breath.
Goose Frontline.
It'll be
okay.
I hate you right now. We drafted Mitchell Trubisky. Okay, so Mike and I were talking about this earlier, and we were saying Julio Jones to the Green Bay Packers would instantly put the Packers up at a Super Bowl pick here.
They're already a fucking Super Bowl contender.
Well, I meant like a Super Bowl lock.
Who?
Julio Jones to the Packers.
To the Packers.
But I mean, like, obviously, that's kind of a little far fetched, like kind of a unrealistic goal,
it's
right?
It's not that far fetched.
But
it really isn't. They'd be the Super Bowl one.
And if the War Wars Dusty Bridgewater is officially out now, so
they would be they would be the best team in the NFC.
So let me make a pitch here. Arizona Cardinals, Larry Fitzgerald really hasn't been used that much in Arizona. Yes,
they're not
he has
trading
been
Larry
there,
Fitzgerald.
But I'm saying here, what if they sent a first round pick over to the Arizona Cardinals for Larry Fitzgerald?
You're not getting Larry Fitzgerald. The Arizona Cardinals will not, but Larry Fitzgerald is the Arizona Cardinals. They're not trading Larry Fitzgerald for anything. I guarantee it. And not only that, but they're not trading Larry Fitzgerald because they're in the thick of it in the NFC West. They're a legit threat to the Seattle Seahawks right now. So they're not trading Larry Fitzgerald.
Mike, who is a trade that you would like to see?
On any team?
Any team, yeah.
Anybody?
Sure.
Just like,
well, I mean, be realistic. Try to be realistic.
Realistic?
Somebody who's available.
I'd like to see the Cowboys make a play for Matt Ryan.
For like a pick or for like a trade?
Are the Falcons going to give up Matt Ryan, though?
No.
They've said that they're not.
But
money talks, right?
They should. They should give up Matt Ryan and Julio Jones and build around Calvin Ridley and restock that offensive line and go get themselves a quarterback in the draft as well.
So the only problem that I see about that is Jameson brought it up earlier in our show, the Mike and Mike Manor at 1 p.m. East Coast time, Monday through Friday, is that if they were to trade those guys to do whatever they want, it would be almost $100 million of dead dollar hit cap hit. So they wouldn't be getting anything in return for those guys. Like, they still got to pay the $100 million to Julio and Matt Ryan.
And that's why I don't think that they'll trade them. I think that Teddy Bridgewater is warming up on the sidelines. I don't know.
Is
but
so let's leave fantasy land and come back to real life here.
Yeah.
AJ Green, Cincinnati Bengals. Clearly he hasn't been.
I don't think he's going to leave. I think he's happy with Joe Burrow. I think AJ Green has another like 2 or 3 years left in him. Obviously the Bengals aren't going to win a championship.
He might be happy, but is the organization happy?
The Burrow thing and Cincinnati not winning a championship might not be as far away as you think.
No, I don't. I agree with you, Brandon. I don't think it's as far away as people may think. I think Cincinnati is the best 1-5 team in football right now.
They are.
They are easily the best 1-5 team. Yeah. But hear me out here. I thought Joe Mixon was going to be a top 5 or a top 10 running back in the NFL this season. Clearly, I was wrong on that.
He's been good.
You are on a lot of things.
He is good, but he is not what people expect him to be, right? Yeah. I think.
Did you have him ranked around above King Henry too?
Below, number 8.
Oh, okay.
But King Henry is still number 7. But moving forward on that,
no, he's not.
I would not be surprised if the Cleveland Browns and Cincinnati Bengals do a interdivision trade, AJ Green for Odell Beckham Jr. and Joe Mixon.
Well, you're not going to trade OBJ right now because he's done for the year with the ACL.
Yeah, but you have
you can't trade a player who's on IR.
Oh, you can't?
No.
Okay. But either way, AJ Green is not going to end up in Cincinnati, not because if he is not happy there, because the organization doesn't see any value in him right now on the field. They see him as value as trade bait. You can get a second or third round pick for AJ Green.
Yeah.
Right now, they're teams out there that can use his services. Green Bay Packers,
agreed.
Miami Dolphins,
Chicago Bears,
San Francisco.
Nobody cares about the Chicago Bears, Brandon.
So look, I'm putting possible people that need wide receivers. Mike LeBlanc.
So Marco Jackson over here on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/MikeAndMikeManHour, says I think AJ Green has found his role in that offense. I don't. Yes and no, but
I think so too. I like AJ Green to stay in Cincinnati.
I really can't take you serious with your avatar is LeBron James. I'm sorry.
LeBron James is the GOAT. That's why he does have the king.
Get out of here with that shit, Buck.
Can you kick him off the show, please? Just kick him off the show.
Oh, my God. There we go.
Thank you.
No, LeBron James is not the fucking GOAT. Michael Jordan is the GOAT.
So one other trade that I thought was very, very intriguing is, like I said earlier, Cam Newton is in New England strictly for trade bait. You kind of beat it around the bush a little bit, say that Patriots are in like a rebuild mode. I don't think they are in a complete rebuild mode. They're looking for a couple offensive guys to really boost that team.
They've got no offensive line. They've got no running back. They've got no wide receivers, and they've got no quarterback.
They're
in a complete rebuild on the offense.
So what you do is you trade Cam Newton for a fifth or sixth round pick to the San Francisco 49ers for Jimmy Garoppolo.
Why are they giving you Jimmy Garoppolo for a fifth or sixth round pick?
Because he's not very good.
He's better just fine for them right now. Why would they do that? They've got a chance at the playoffs right now. Why are they trading Jimmy Garoppolo?
The 49ers?
The 49ers.
They're going to miss with 7-9. Come on now.
They're 4-3.
49ers will miss the playoffs.
7-9.
I don't know, but they've been playing. Look, I'm with you. I'm not high on the 49ers at all. I'm definitely not high on Jimmy Garoppolo, but I'm definitely not. I'm a believer in what they've been doing and how they've been doing it. I mean, they've been surprising teams, and the way that they won last weekend. I mean, look, I'm all right with it. I think that they might end up 9-7 and make the playoffs in the NFC. Absolutely.
So there,
I think you might get three teams out of the West.
There is a quarterback that we are overlooking in this trade deadline here. Look no further than the Washington football team, Dwayne Haskins. He was benched, a couple weeks ago for Kyle Allen. Do the Washingtons try to deal him at all?
Look, man, look, and I keep saying it, and I know people think I'm a homer because I say it. That's another guy I wouldn't mind seeing on the Bears. That's another guy who I think makes the Bears a contender. I got a question
for Colts.
What?
We're talking about trades, right?
Yep.
You think the Cowboys should go out and get a quarterback?
Yep.
Two trade proposals. Jacoby Brissett. Trade for Jacoby Brissett. Or trade for Jameis Winston.
Going to the Cowboys, right?
I would trade for Jacoby Brissett because Jacoby Brissett is ready to win now. Jameis Winston could win now in that New Orleans scheme, and he's going to be the New Orleans quarterback of the future. I think the smartest thing that kid did was go to New Orleans to be a backup, because he went to New Orleans to learn under Drew Brees, and I think that's going to help him tremendously moving forward with the New Orleans Saints. I would love to see Jacoby Brissett go to Dallas. I think if Jacoby Brissett goes to Dallas. Dallas, you know, I mean, they still need defensive help, but Dallas is infinitely better with Jacoby Brissett.
Agreed.
Jacoby Brissett has won like as well. I mean, they were 8-1, yeah. I believe, with the Colts before the injury bug caught up to them.
And I can't wait to see what Sean Payton does with Jameis Winston. I think that's going to be a match made in heaven once he takes over next year.
Do you think Drew Brees just retires and rides off?
Yeah, Drew Brees is done after this year. You could see it now. I mean, Drew Brees is done now. He's not the same Drew Brees. He's not as mobile. He is completing 70% of his passes, but he's completing 70% of his passes because he's not throwing further than 15 yards.
That's his MO though. It's nickel and dime.
Yeah, deep. So. They do go deep quite a bit with Michael Thomas, and they do throw Gina. But I think he's done. I think he's done after this year. I just think he's too old. So, noodle arm. I mean, people said that about Tom Brady, but I think that's more true about Brees than it is Brady.
I think it's harder to throw it in New England than it is at Tampa, so your arm strength gets exposed more.
That's also why I have the Bears this week against New Orleans, because it's in Chicago. You got the elements. It's going to be cooler. It's going to be windy. And I think that favors the Bears more than the Saints, because I feel like Drew Brees has definitely benefited throughout his career by being an indoor quarterback. If he had to play, you know, the rest of his career in San Diego, I don't think he would have been the same Drew Brees that he has been in New Orleans.
Okay, guys. So I'm going to throw out some like names. Two teams here on this NFL trade deadline coming up, and on November 3rd. Tell me if this trade makes that team better or worse. Okay, Stephon Gilmore to the Seattle Seahawks. Pete Carroll and John Snyder have both said they are very, very interested in him after adding Jamal Adams, even though he has had injury plagued season.
The Seahawks will become.
Is on their radar.
Wow. The Seahawks become my favorite to win the NFC.
Yes.
If they do that.
Yeah. Stephon Gilmore to the Seahawks, you're looking at Legion of Boom 2.0.
Yeah. And they also just added Carlos Dunlap from the Bengals to fix that front seven that I said was absolutely horrible. Next up is AJ Green to the Patriots. The Patriots have gone to the cream of the crop when walking the tightrope in 2020. And they basically flat out said that they no longer have offensive firepower. AJ Green would bring that to him and give Cam Newton the confidence that he needs.
He missed the extra point. Carolina's got a shot. But no, I don't believe that anything makes New England a contender this year. They need so much offensive line help. They need a running back. Again, they still need a quarterback. Granted, you get AJ Green, but who's throwing him the ball? If you get AJ Green, I guess if you're buying as opposed to selling, but you're not. If you're doing that, then why are you getting rid of Gilmore?
Right. True story.
I mean, like. I don't think New England is even playoff bound this season. I think this season is a wash, and I think after this season, I mean, I do. And I was so high on Cam Newton coming into the season, but like after watching him play and everything like that, I think the Cam Newton experience is over after this season, and they move on from Cam, and I think they start rebuilding. Honestly, I think Bill Belichick starts rebuilding.
So the next up is Alshon Jeffries, Philadelphia Eagles wide receiver, to the Green Bay Packers. We have been saying that the Green Bay Packers need receiver help. Ooh. And the Philadelphia Eagles have one receiver that's healthy, and that's Alshon Jeffries. What do you guys think?
Man, Alshon Jeffries on one side and Devontae Adams on the other side. This offense is already scary. The defense is already really good. That I mean, I think right now the Green Bay Packers are the best team in the NFC, and if you add Alshon Jeffries to that, I mean, forget it. Just hand them the NFC Championship trophy and see who they play in the Super Bowl.
Yeah,
that's what I think.
I'm totally with that. Gives Aaron Rodgers two very, very good weapons in Devontae Adams, and then Alshon Jeffries. Fucking Aaron Rodgers is surgical.
Yeah.
Are they a receiver away from being a lock in the Super Bowl?
I think they're a lock in the Super Bowl now.
I think Seattle could beat them.
I think they're a lock in the NFC Championship.
Yeah, for sure.
For sure. I think it's going to come down between Green Bay and Seattle.
Yeah. And Green Bay and Tampa Bay could be the thing, too.
Yeah you guys totally just read
it. It's going to come down to the quarterback play in the NFC Championship, and it's going to come down to defensive play.
Tom Brady versus Aaron Rodgers in the NFC Championship game.
I would love that.
Tom Brady and the Bucks go to the Super Bowl.
One more here. With the issues in New Orleans with Michael Thomas, you know, being sat out of games, arguing with like teammates, fighting him, Houston has put all the receivers up for sale. What about Kenny Stills to the New Orleans Saints?
Ooh. I kind of like that, honestly.
If you're going after a Houston wide receiver, I think I like going after, if he can stay healthy, I like Will Fuller more than I like Kenny Stills. If he can stay healthy. But man, why? If you're Houston, man, and you like, just please let Deshaun Watson out of his contract. Like, stop doing that to this man. This man is a Hall of Fame type quarterback if you freaking build around him. And what they've done to him is just waste his damn career. They wasted him with Bill O'Brien, and they're wasting him again. They're trading away everything. Let the man out of his contract.
And let him go to the Cowboys.
I kind of feel like Houston seems like they're trying to clean house and just totally build from scratch. Duke Johnson, their running back, to the Buffalo Bills. I mean, the Buffalo Bills are already probably a playoff bound team anyways. Does Duke Johnson really skip him over that edge?
Let's do Deshaun Watson to the Bears, where he should have gone, for Mitch Trubisky. Straight up. Let's just do the draft pick we should have taken for the draft pick that we did take. But no. Duke Johnson to where, did you say?
Buffalo Bills.
Ooh. I like their run game, though, man. I like their young running backs. But Duke Johnson...
Singletary's pretty good, I think.
He is. He's very good. Man, it gives you another threat. I think their problem is more wide receiver. I think they need one more wide receiver more than they need a running back. So if you look at the receiver, I wouldn't do that one.
I mean, they got Cole Beasley there. They got Stephon Diggs.
I would do it if you can give me Duke Johnson and you can give me Will Fuller. I think I'd do a deal with you if I'm the Bills.
Does that put him in the Super Bowl?
That puts him in the AFC title game.
No, it doesn't. I don't think it puts them in the AFC title game.
Yeah, they're better. If they do that, they're better than Baltimore is.
I think there's a lot of teams better than Baltimore right now.
I think that
puts them right up there with Kansas City. That front seven is nasty.
You are correct on that. 100% correct. With Oliver on there, I mean that kind of puts them in a top five.
I can definitely see the Steelers and the if you do that. I can see the Steelers and the Bills in the AFC Championship.
So Loco Jackson says, what about the running back Johnson from the Lions to the Bills? I'm not for sure who the running back Johnson is.
Kerryon Johnson. Okay.
See, I don't think the Buffalo Bills are a running back away. I like Singletary. I think Singletary is doing a great job in there, and they got is Frank Gore up there? No, Frank.
If
Gore
I'm the Lions, though, I can't give up. I can't give up pieces if I'm the Lions.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
The Lions aren't that far away from winning. The Lions, and I know you picked them, and I know I trashed on you for picking them at 10-6. But the Lions aren't that far away. I really like Matthew Stafford.
They're a receiver away. I think.
I like, you know what?
Galladay's very underrated.
I like
Galladay's a very good wide receiver.
I like Matthew Stafford to the Cowboys. Or
come on, stop with the Cowboys.
I like Matthew Stafford to the Patriots.
Ooh, look, all right, back to Buck and Combs Man Hour.
just to add to that, I wanted Matthew Stafford to come to the Dallas earlier in the off season.
I really like Matthew Stafford to the Patriots. Honestly, I think he fits Bill Belichick's system.
The Lions aren't giving rid of Matthew Stafford.
No, they're not.
He's a lifer. So let's flash back to the Lions here. Could they be in play for some Houston receivers since they're trying to clear a house there? You know, Will Fuller the fifth, Randall Cobb, Kenny Stills. Who else they have there?
Rumor had it that they were in the market for Will Fuller.
And the Packers too. So,
but does anything make the Lions a contender this year? I don't think that they're a contender this year either.
I don't think so either. They need some help on defense and they need key pieces on offense. And I think they get that in the draft this year. I don't think the Lions are going to get over that hump this year. Next year, if they add those key pieces in the draft,
do they need to get rid of Patricia?
No, he is doing good things there. It takes time to build a culture in a organization, especially with professional athletes. So that's why
I haven't said anything about like fire Mike McCarthy. Mike Nolan needs to go, right? But I don't think
Mike McCarthy's a horrible.
I don't think he needs to go yet. Let him build,
Mike McCarthy. Talk to Green Bay fans and ask you how they feel about Mike McCarthy.
So let's address this Mike McCarthy situation before we have to go here. You can literally have the best team on pay. So you can take the Kansas City Chiefs from last year and put Mike McCarthy on that Kansas City Chiefs team. They are not going to be as good because Mike McCarthy
they
doesn't
don't win
have
the Super Bowl.
Well, but I'm saying it takes time for a coach to put in his system to bring in the players that he needs.
Mike
to
McCarthy,
run the,
he had all that time in Green Bay, and what did he do with it? He won one Super Bowl with all that time in Green Bay with a guy who a lot of people think might be the best quarterback in football right now. A lot of people like to say that he's better than Tom Brady. I don't think so. He's very, very good. Aaron Rodgers is very good, and I hate to say it, but I mean he is. He's probably a top five quarterback of all time. Yeah. But Mike McCarthy couldn't do nothing with that. And they didn't build around him. And Mike McCarthy was the GM of that team. They never built around Aaron Rodgers. They didn't do anything for Aaron Rodgers.
So it is very hard to become a GM and a head coach. Let's be flat out honest. It is hard to do two huge jobs at once. We've seen Bill O'Brien fail at it in Houston, right?
Yeah.
We are seeing there was also a coach GM for San Francisco 49, or no, was it Oakland that John Gruden was a GM and the head coach like too?
Yeah, Oakland.
He didn't survive either. It's very, very hard because it is hard to make front office decisions when you are the front office and it affects you on the field, right?
Yeah.
And also to flash back to those Packers teams, the NFC was pretty good then. Let's be flat out honest. The NFC was pretty stout when Mike McCarthy and the Packers were in their quote heydays, right?
Yep.
Are you disagreeing?
Yeah. I mean, the NFC hasn't really been strong. This is the strongest the NFC's been in a long time.
I'm not saying they are strong from 1 to 16, but that 1 through 5, it was strong. I mean, you ran into some pretty good Detroit Lions teams, you ran into some pretty good Minnesota Vikings teams. The Chicago Bears,
but the Packers were better than them, better than all of those teams. They should have beaten all the, and they just weren't. They half the time they weren't getting out of the first round. They were losing at home. Yes. You know what I mean? Like I don't think I'm not a big fan of Mike. I thought the hire of Mike McCarthy was bad. I think, you know, if I had to revert it to baseball, I think it's almost as bad as the White Sox hiring Tony La Russa. I just think the hire of Mike McCarthy was just an awful hire.
I don't know. Awful, I mean, in hire. The end, only time will tell. But let's address this comment before we head out, guys. Loco Jackson from the YouTube channel, youtube.com/MikeAndMikeManHour. Hit that subscribe button. Says, can we agree the Steelers win against the Ravens and the Chiefs, they're going to the Super Bowl?
I agree with you that if they lose to the Steelers or if they lose to the Ravens and the Chiefs, they're going to the Super Bowl.
Yeah, they're the best team in football.
They're the best team in football.
Yeah. Like
I
think they're going to be the best team in football from here on out. Big Ben was
– Barring injury.
Right. Yeah, barring injury. Big Ben has something to prove. Everybody thought he was washed up.
I agree.
Thought he was done, and he's got something to prove.
I have seen nothing from the Steelers – through the first, what are we? They're 7-0. Through the first seven games, I've seen nothing from the Pittsburgh Steelers that would suggest that they aren't everything that they are.
They in the second half versus the Tennessee Titans game, they let their foot off the gas a little bit, and they showed a little bit of weakness. So they just need to make sure they keep the hammer down the whole game.
I agree.
That's the only thing I can think of. So,
guys,
that's going to be it for the Man Hour. Check us out next Tuesday, 10 p.m. East Coast time. Combs and myself will be on here. Mike, you're always welcome to join us as well.
It's my fucking show.
On that Man Hour After Hours, you can check out Mike and Mike.
Bye, Mike.
Hour, Monday through Friday, 1 p.m. East Coast time. So, guys, any closing thoughts before we head out? Mike, I'll give you 1 minute.
Hey, Mike, why don't you tell the people where they can find you?
Oh, hey, you can find me on Man Hour right here.
The Man Hour before dark, during kitty time.
Hey, you can find us on the Mike and Mike Man Hour, Monday through Friday, 12 noon Central Standard Time, 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. and 10 p.m. East or West Coast time.
Yeah, but you're not always on that one, though.
My closing thoughts are just like they are. Here are my closing thoughts on the Mike and Mike Man Hour. We all love to joke around and we rib each other. We all love each other. We love you. We need to love each other. And just go peace and happiness. Cheers.
All right, guys. Have a great night. Mike and Mike Man Hour. MikeAndMikeManHour.com. Check us out. And After Hours, of course, here, over there. Brandon, have a good night, man.
Fair foul. Rep blow the whistle. Coach throw the towel. We can do this on the field, on side of the lines. It's the Man Hour, though. Now we going live.